shot by Mackey. That went just wide. They get it off the boards and score. Taylor Mackey. There's another one of those. Shot that misses, comes off the end boards. Boards, backhand, scores! Shot by Mackey. That went just wide. They get it off the boards and score. Taylor Mackey. There's another one of those. Shot that misses, comes off the end boards. Boards, backhand, scores! Shot by Mackey. That went just wide. They get it off the boards and score. Taylor Mackey. There's another one of those. Shot that misses, comes off the end boards. Boards, backhand, scores! Shot by Mackey. That went just wide. They get it off the boards and score. Taylor Mackey. There's another one of those. Shot that misses, comes off the end boards.
And we welcome you back inside the Merlis Belcher Place in Saskatoon, Saskatchewan, arena number one. And we are getting set for a semifinal. Girls under 20, Newfoundland and Labrador selects. To your left, with the blue, red, and the Manitoba North Stars, green and gold. And we are underway in this girls' semi-final game. Winner, of course, will play for the gold tomorrow. Brought in, Kitchen. Kitchen with a shot. And the save is made. First chance for Newfoundland and Labrador. Abby Glass in goal for Manitoba. For Newfoundland and Labrador, it's Maggie Jones. 2-on-1 for Manitoba. Save made by Jones. Another save by Jones. Got the first shot and got one on the rebound. So both goaltenders have been tested early. It's a flooring call against Newfoundland and Labrador. Hey, if Newfoundland and Labrador are playing, why not play heave away? Not that they haven't been playing it all week. Seem to hear that song everywhere you go these days. The hockey arena you go to, it's become a ubiquitous hockey song. This was used for the Canadian Juniors, their goal song. The Canadian Juniors, here we go, in Halifax. Song by Newfoundland and Labrador's and Navigators. Anyway, back to the hockey. Stop at center, by Manitoba. Get it in. Back to pick it up, Spencer. To Edmonds, and that'll go into the players' bench. Territory around behind the goal. Looking for it back there is Martel for Manitoba. She's got it. Puts it to Burns. And again, up into the Newfoundland and Labrador players' bench. If I've seen that before. Referee waiting for the players to line up and likes that song apparently. He was dancing away. Not often you see the referees dancing on the floor. Coaching. Behind the goal, player goes down. Net has become dislodged, the reason for the whistle. Manitoba player shaking up a little bit. Right hand. It's Jesse Zikowitz. She's going to head off. She bent the wrist back the way she's holding it. Hopefully she will be okay. Key player for Manitoba. Gill played it ahead. They get it down into Manitoba territory. Manitoba get it and get it down the floor. That'll be a flooring call against the North Stars. Backhand stopped by Glass. On it is Nimitz. Move it out. Don't get it very far. Long shot in. Glass has got it. Glass kept it going. Miscommunication with her defense. And that led to a chance for Newfoundland and Labrador. Kept in. Gill with a backhand. It was off the end boards. Jones. Jones will hold on to it. Last year, the girls' divisions were U19 and U16. They've been that way for a number of years. This year, they decided to go U20 and U17. They have extensively new champions in each division, or the first-time champions in these divisions. Last year, Newfoundland Labrador won the U19. Kitchen. This year, most of these girls who are on that U19 team are on the U20. Emma Powell. It's by everybody at the blue line. Wasn't tipped, so again we'll be flooring against Manitoba. During the preliminary round, Newfoundland and Labrador were a perfect 4-0, Manitoba 2-2. This is the 1-4 semifinal. Standing behind the Newfoundland and Labrador net, comes up along the boards. Butler trying to get it out. It comes up into the seats just below us. In our U23 semifinals, the 1-4, the 4-seed won, and in the 2-3, the 3-seed won, so who knows? Shot in wide of the goal by Maggie Matani. Georgeson, she goes down. That's going to be a penalty to Newfoundland and Labrador, tripping likely. Comes with 10:33 left to go in the first period. No score between these two teams. McMaster's shot was stopped. Was it along the goal line? Back to McMaster. Back up top, Matani, her shot, deflects, and what a save by Maggie Jones, acrobatic. The shot came in, changed direction, look at this. Change, catch, and let's do a little barrel roll while we're at it. A little flare. See that every day. Back up, Matani. Maggie Matani sends it the other side. She'll get it back. Shot right on goal. Jones has to make the save behind the net. Jamie Guy will clear it. Spencer. She gets pushed against the board, strapped there. She'll try and hold it. Finally, it comes free. Hyatt. Matani. McMaster back to Matani. That one goes in wide of the goal. ...25 seconds to go in the power play. Back up top, Matani. into the slot area. Can't get a shot through to the goal. Swing and a miss there by Gortzen. Now she's got it. Gortzen with a shot. That hit somebody towards the goal. That's going to do it. The penalty has now expired. Paige Noble from Newfoundland and Labrador heads to the bench. Shot saved by Jones. So far, Manitoba giving Newfoundland and Labrador all they can handle and then some. Even strength, they still maintain the ball down in the Newfoundland and Labrador end. Off the glass. Matani will keep it in. Maggie Matani. Cuts inside. Tried to beat a couple of defenders. Tough to do. That was knocked off her stick. Huckaluck. Shot down into the corner. On it over there is Hiptich. That's knocked down. Kept in. Emma Powell. She knocked down and play continues on. Up to Butler. Butler in over the blue line. Butler one-on-one. Butler with a shot. Stopped by Glass. Rebound. Couldn't get a stick on it. Down the boards it goes. Over to Hyatt. Hyatt can't get it out. Edmonds is on her right away. Come here to the near side. Dumped in by Huckaluck. Butler to Hardy, still in. Alicia Powell, her shot rolls into Jones, has to sweep it away. The net was moved, reason for that whistle. Both teams change. 6:41 to go, first period, no score. Girls under 20 semifinal. Punch your ticket to the national championship game tomorrow. Do they still punch tickets? Is everything electronic these days? I ask myself. Back of the point, shot comes in, wide of the goal. Spencer. Hiptich. Ahead. Simpson. Simpson the other side. Shot comes in, Glass with the save. Down in that corner, it's stuck to the boards. Now it comes three and Manitoba will bring it out. It's Matani down into the corner. Shot wide. Guy. Goodger. They'll just send it down the floor. That's going to go right on goal. Glass will leave it for her defense. Powell. Newberry trying to keep it in. It comes out. Going back to get it. Hiptich. To Hardy. Can't get it out. Gortzen spins away from the forechecker and heads up the floor. She's poke checked, but will get it down. Paige Noble. Ooh, nobody on Newfoundland and Labrador could touch it. Neither could anybody on Manitoba. They were both changing. Anybody touched it, it would have been too many players on the floor. Prochick, she stopped. Kitchen drops it. Long shot in, wide. Rebound is poked behind the goal by Saunders. Saunders has it, feeds it out in front. Nobody there for Newfoundland and Labrador. Tipped away by Jesse Zikowitz. Wondering if she was okay. She went off shaking her hand earlier, but back out there. Apparently nothing serious. That's good to hear. And that's going to be a penalty. Interference. Pretty easy call there at center. Newfoundland Labrador about to go on the power play. Kitchen will face off against Hyatt. Hyatt wins it and unable to clear it is Manitoba. Now they'll clear it. Jones comes out and plays it all the way up at the center red line. Ryan drops it back. Molly Gill. Gill didn't get it in deep. Now they'll bring it in. Butler. Back to Gill, her shot wide. Comes out in front, scramble there, and gets past Allie Spencer. At center, again, goaltender, the long pass, played in. Gill, in front, shot, saved by Glass, rebound is there, cleared to the boards. On it is Hyatt. Hyatt for Manitoba turns, kept in, Guy. Guy gave it away. Gortson working against Guy. He'll take it all the way down to the end boards. Hold it there. Kill some time. Guy's on her. They'll hold it against the boards. 40 seconds left. Gortson doing a great job. Gortson still got it. Killing precious seconds. Finally, they take it away from her. But great work by Gortson. Gill can't get to it. Mitani. But declared and it went into the Manitoba bench. So break for Newfoundland and Labrador. 10 seconds left. Face off in the Manitoba zone. Spencer, long shot wide of the goal. Simpson backhands it wide. That'll do it. Penalty's over. Turning, backhand wide of the goal. It was Drover. Ball comes to the near boards. Simpson can't get free. Now Simpson's got it into the center, cleared away. Simpson's got it again, hopped over her stick. It's Burns. She'll shoot it in and head to the bench. In forechecking, Hyatt. Taken away by Spencer. Up to Drover. Delacqua. Cleared down the four, and this is likely going to go as a flooring. There's the whistle. Thank you. to Bailey McMaster. Newfoundland Labrador come away with it. That's a little too far. Jamie Guy played it off the boards. Will be another flooring call against the selects. There's Maggie Matani. Still playing in the under 20. I've been doing this 7 years. It feels like Maggie Batani's been at every event. Don't know if that's possible. Playing junior for Manitoba. Terrific young player. Drifts that one in wide. That's chipped away. Racing after it. Gill, Molly Gill. Stops it. Plays it back. Newberry with a shot. Glass makes the save. No rebound. Down to just 7.5 seconds to go here in the first period. It's gone by quickly. Shot wide. Come to the boards. Maybe one last chance if they can get it in front quickly. They don't. Manitoba's got it, and the buzzer will go, and first period will come to an end. No score between these two teams. Manitoba hanging in there against the number one seed, Newfoundland and Labrador, perhaps had the better of the play through the first period. Get the shots on goal posted sometime during the intermission. Lengthy 2 minute intermission. We'll be back with period number two in just a couple of minutes. No score between these two teams as we start period number two. Newfoundland and Labrador, who are 4-0 in the preliminary rounds. Manitoba 2-2. It's the 1-4 matchup. And so far, give the edge to the number four seed. Better play in that first period. back in the Newfoundland and Labrador end now. That little back pass out in front, that was picked off. Newfoundland and Labrador send it down the floor, racing to get to it. Julia Butler. And there's a collision down in the corner. It's going to be a penalty. It's going to go against Maggie Matani. Body contact. A power play, Newfoundland and Labrador. Kitchen will take the faceoff for Newfoundland and Labrador. Manitoba win it, take it behind the goal. Alicia Powell to the boards. Powell will keep it herself and send it down the floor. Spencer forced back by Procek, who's in there forechecking. Back to Spencer. Up to Butler. Butler gains his own. There's it back in along the boards. That shot stopped. There's Kitchen. Glass with another save. Back to Spencer. Snap it around, and that's broken up. Butler. Spencer, Ryan, into the slot, Gill with a shot, Glass stops that. Just under a minute left to go in the power play. Labrador player moved out of the faceoff circle. Ball goes to the corner, off the boards. It'll be kept in by Guy. Guy to Gill. Circle looking for Gill. Rebound and scores! That was an intended pass that was blocked and then came right to the Newfoundland and Labrador player. And it is 1-0, Newfoundland and Labrador. Appears to be Julia Butler. This is a pass that hit somebody, comes to Butler. She was not the intended target at all. They're trying to get it over here to the player at the right post. Unfortunate break there for Manitoba. Lucky one for Newfoundland and Labrador. And it is 1-0. Hipditch. Over the other side, picked up over there by Brooke Hipditch. We got Kendra and Brooke Hipditch out there for Newfoundland and Labrador. Guy going back in her own end to get it. Delacqua go up into the seats. Cleared in. Hustling back there. Simpson gets there first for Newfoundland and Labrador. Jenny Simpson. Got to get it to Hipditch. It's up along the boards. Pinching in Spencer will come out towards center. And great job to hold it in by Batcock. She's got it again. Touch somebody over at the bench. Tani. To Huckluck, she'll get the return pass. What was intended for, a little bit too far, and that'll be a flooring call. It's a good thought, just failed in the execution. Against McMaster, and Manitoba player encroached to the faceoff circle, so McMaster will come out. Coming in to take the faceoff was Solinsky. Goes to the far boards, on it first over there is Newbury. He lost it, comes out towards center. It's still onside, hasn't come out yet. Now Manitoba with a chance to move it. Matani, Maggie Matani, shot wide of the goal. Goes to the boards. Back to Matani. Matani with a shot that goes wide of the goal. Back at the point. Wrist shot in. Deflects wide. On it first, Ryan. Along the boards. Nimitz. Manitoba with a good shift here, keeping Newfoundland and Labrador pinned in their own end. Spencer around the boards. Nimitz pinching in. She'll hold it in. Solinsky working hard. Spencer around the boards. Will be kept in by Manitoba here on this side. Into the slot. Shot. That goes wide. Solinsky stepped into that one. Guy. Actually, that was Batcock. Rattles around in front. Nobody can get a stick on it. Crease violation against Manitoba. So the faceoff will come outside the blue line. 1-0, Newfoundland and Labrador. Shots on goal, by the way, in that first period. They've now got it posted 9-7 in favor of Manitoba. And as I said, I thought Manitoba really had the edge in play in that first period. Face-off just outside the blue line. Got Kitchen against Gortson. There's Gortson. Shot in on Jones. Jones has got it. She will hold on to it. Under 10 to play in period number two. Gortson in all alone, a shot stopped by Jones, and she's got it under the pads and will stop the play right there. Jenna Gortson with a great chance to equalize this one. Right from the faceoff, she's got it, gets it to her forehand, and boy, there was a bit of space between the pads of Jones. Squeezes him just in time to keep the ball out. Delacqua gave it away. Fleet Fleet trying to break in. Fleet is to the forehand. Diving out, Glass has got it. Chance for Abby Fleet. Kitchen won the faceoff, but taken by Manitoba down the left side. Burns working against Hardy. Saunders pinned against the boards. Four players over there. Looking it back towards the blue line. Saying move it. They're saying we're trying. We're trying. Kept in by Manitoba. Noble fires it around the boards. Kept in. It's Emma Powell. The Flannel Labrador player went down. Back of the point. Shot goes in over the top of the goal. It's played in front. The Flannel Labrador get it away. It is not out. Now it is. Kitchen is stopped. Good play. Westendorf. Jones leaves it for Noble. Newfoundland Labrador forced to just get rid of it down the floor. Won't be enough for flooring. Play continues. Emma Powell around the boards, kept in by Guy. Into the slot, area shot. Glass made the save, the rebound is there, it's still loose. Another chance, stopped by Glass. Guy has got it knocked off her stick. Back out towards center. And to hold it in, Hiptich. Cleared up by Manitoba, will go down all the way to Maggie Jones. She gave it away. Selinski's got it for Manitoba. Selinski, her shot, that was blocked by the defense, didn't get through to the goaltender up at the blue line. Drover. Was trying to get it to Butler, that was intercepted by Matani. Matani heads up the floor. Maggie Matani squeezes by Jamie Guy, and Jamie Guy is going to get a penalty. Two minutes for body contact. This is Jamie Guy heading to the penalty box. Maggie Matani. Matani. Off the foot. Rebound was put wide. In behind the goal, looking for it. Procek. Powell. Good pass. Went through the crease. Kept in by Zikowicz. Back out to Matani. Doesn't shoot it. McMaster shot. Kicked away. Krochik. McMaster. Matani. Shot. Wide of the goal. McMaster's got it again along the boards. Down to Krochik. Krochik. We come all the way back. Matani. Shot in wide of the goal. Played away by the goaltender anyway. It's Zikowicz. Zikowicz got it along the boards. He goes down. Both players go down. It comes back to Matani looking for the deflection. Dortson got a stick on it. It rattles around. Couple of saves by Jones, and she'll hold on. And we are going to get a penalty at the end of this one. Two officials confer. Dana Dortson. Two minutes roughing. Captain of Manitoba, Maggie Matani, questioning that call, probably questioning why only one player went to the box. Quite often you see those scrums after a save and there's a crowd pushing and shoving that both players go. Simpson comes over and says, okay, if you're talking to her, I want to know what's going on. The penalty against Manitoba, the faceoff will move back in their end. Got a discussion over at the Newfoundland and Labrador bench. Referee talking to the coaches. Drover holding it. Power play for Newfoundland and Labrador. Batcock. Shot didn't get through. Goes to the boards. Fired around the other side. Getting there first will be Prochick. He'll turn. Get it out. Short-handed. On it. Zikowicz gets the shot on goal. It's going to force Jones to make a save and a faceoff in the Newfoundland and Labrador end. Under five to go in period number two, just the one goal. There's that last shot, no trouble for Jones there. 1:20 left to go in the power play for Newfoundland and Labrador. Chipped ahead, trying to race onto it as Butler. She gets it down a little bit deeper. Matani's back there. Holds it against the boards. And Labrador send a second player in there. See, Matani's got that ball between the feet. Finally, it comes loose. And who's going to get to it? Flan Labrador, defenseman Guy, hesitated. And now they come away. Hyatt with a shot. Jones makes the save. Sweeps it to the boards, but over there is Burns. Great penalty killing by Manitoba. Hyatt in there again, causing all kinds of problems for Newfoundland and Labrador. Hold it against the boards down there. Time ticking away in this power play. They can't get it away from her. Finally they do, but there's only 22 seconds to go in the power play now. It's brought in. They'll drop it back. Guy swings it the other side. Ryan for Kitchen. Kitchen, Ryan, save made. In front, they score! Molly Gill. Kitchen to Ryan to Gill, and it is 2-0. Nice back pass by Ryan. Finds Gill in the slot, and she buries it. So a 2-0 lead now, late in the second period. Spencer. Simpson. Gortson breaks that up. To Zikowicz. Looking for Procic. Spencer's got it. Spencer taking it around behind the goal. Procic. And trying to tie her up behind the goal. Comes up along the boards. Two players there. Manitoba player goes down. And it goes up into the seats. Manitoba will change. The Flannel Labrador will stand pat. 2:45 to go here in the second. Simpson. She can't bring it out. Stopped. Selinski. There's a chance for Manitoba. The shot from McMaster. And Jones is right there. There's a chance for McMaster. Jones makes the save. Smothers it. Goes into the Newfoundland and Labrador bench. It back. That shot by Butler was stopped. It comes out towards the blue line, and Manitoba get there first and clear it down the floor. It's reversed by Batcock up ahead. Butler. Edmonds looking for Hardy. Her backhand was off a stick and over the top of the goal. Kept in. Butler. Butler off the boards. Butler puts it towards the goal, goes in behind. Give and go. Butler's got it from a very sharp angle, went behind the net. Edmonds. Shot on goal from a tough angle. Manitoba couldn't get it out. It'll be kept in. Kitchen. Kitchen. All the way out to center, backhands it off the boards. Made in by Batcock. Butler was looking for it. 1 minute to go in the second period. And finally, Manitoba able to get it out of their own end. They race up the floor. Emma Powell, shot goes in wide of the net. That goes up into the mesh. We'll get a face-off in the Newfoundland and Labrador end. Just under 45 seconds left to go here in the second period. Guy up through the middle, then onto the left wing. Fleet hit by everybody. Pass back at the point. Shot goes into the corner. 20 seconds to go in the period. Zikowicz knocked off first, taking the last second. Good play by Guy. Comes out and Fleet has it. Fleet into the middle. Gill. Actually, Ryan. She had it knocked off her stick just as the buzzer goes. 2-0, Newfoundland and Labrador after 30 minutes of play in this girls under 20 semifinal. Winner plays for the national championship tomorrow. Loser plays for the bronze. We'll be back in just under 2 minutes with period number 3. Two to nothing, Newfoundland and Labrador. Selects lead this game over the Manitoba North Stars. Girls under 20 semifinal, starting the third period. Shot over the top of the net, around the boards, comes out the other side. Stopped at center, no further than the blue line. It's Procik. To Zikowicz, looking for Gortzman. If they could get it to her, they couldn't. Back at the point, Matani hit someone in front, that hit Gortzman, and she turns and fires it wide. Batcock off the boards, back at the blue line, Matani, Gortzman. Back to Matani, looking for a deflection. It goes to the boards, Gortzman's on it. Up into the Newfoundland and Labrador players bench. Ball goes into the corner. Huckluck's got it. Into the middle. Finds McMaster. McMaster with a shot. Scores! Bailey McMaster has cut the lead to 1. Mistake by Newfoundland and Labrador. They had pretty good possession of it. Turned it over right onto the stick of McMaster. Up high, no chance there. All right, so they've been playing Newfoundland and Labrador at least even, maybe even a little better throughout most of this game. And they find themselves down by just 1. Westendorf. Kaylee Selinski picks up an assist on the goal by McMaster. And behind the goal, looking for it back there is Goodyear. Goodyear's got it. Grace Goodyear. Still looking around. Get it in front of the net, defend it well by Manitoba, then sent down the floor. This is going to be a flooring call against the Manitoba North Stars. An early goal here in this third period has changed this game around. Knocked down by Newfoundland and Labrador. A shot went off a leg into the corner. Threw it in front looking for Butler. Edmonds looking for it. Played away by Hyatt. Hyatt into the corner. Edmonds all over her. From a sharp angle, Butler got a shot right on goal. Glass made the save. In forechecking, Drover. Cassie Drover in along the boards. Cycles it back down low. Edmonds looking for it. Butler with a shot and then poked wide by Drover. This will be kept in out at center. Hipditch into the middle of the floor it comes and played down a little deeper. Glass has got it. Glass leaves it for defense. Newfoundland Labrador changing off the boards. Trying to catch up to it, Procic. And there was Guy, Jamie Guy's got it. Here comes Newfoundland and Labrador. Abby Fleet. Turned it over. Here comes Burns. Looking for Martel. Fed it out in front, just a little off the mark, and Newfoundland and Labrador will turn and head out. Matani. Kept in on the far side by Gill. Saunders goes to the boards. Matani stopped at the blue line. Can't go any further than that. So hold it there as long as you can. Is still loose. Patani kicks it, but unsportsmanlike. We'll go against Maggie Matani. Power play, Newfoundland and Labrador. A They've called a timeout to set up this power play, leading by just one. The second goal now on the power play would be huge. Or another goal to make it a 3-1 lead, a two-goal lead. Kitchen setting up here on the power play. Right in front, Gill couldn't get the shot away. Butler's got it. Kitchen. Back at the point. Ryan. Goes wide into the corner. Delacqua. And that'll get out. Spencer. To Gill, they get it in over the blue line. Try and give it back to Gill. She'll track it down in the corner. Kitchen, Guy shoots it off the glove of glass and then off the glass, behind glass. Guy keeps it in. Gill in front, scores! Gill with the pass into the slot. Player didn't get a lot on it, but enough to sneak it past Abby Glass. That's Molly Gill, her second of the game. From the same sort of spot, the other one down the other end of the floor, but in the slot area. There it is. See, she didn't get all of it, kind of went off the heel of her stick, but Glass never did get really set for that. And there is that two-goal lead restored. Just over nine to go. Dumped in. Westendorf back to get it. Hyatt. Batcock, Ryan and Butler get the assists. Jones running a little bit of interference there for her defenseman. Get away with it. Spencer over to the other side. It'll be kept in. Chance to move it out, they do. Grace Goodyear. And Goodyear was knocked down, likely interference. She tried to chip it past the defenseman. Emma Powell picks up two for interference. Get past Guy at the blue line, and she's going to have to go all the way back into her own end. Newfoundland Labrador on the power play. Just about 8 minutes left to go in this game. They lead it by two. It's knocked down. Butler. Shot wide of the goal. Ryan on it. Haley Ryan. Down into the corner. Leave it for Ryan. Go the other side. Kitchen. Back to Guy. Back to Kitchen. Steps in, shoots wide. Haley Ryan, this side. 1 minute to go in the power play. Gill passed it off. Rebound comes out and is put over the top of the net. Gill had it there in the slot again. I thought she would shoot it. Liked it to make the pass. Didn't quite work. Goaltender got a stick on that. Ricochets all the way back to center where Jamie Guy has it. Guy through Ryan. Down low. Fed it in front. It bounces around and Glass has it. And Glass will hold on. 6:42 to go in the game. I should say in regulation as we do have overtime now that we are into the playoffs. 29 seconds to go in the power play. You see Glass put the ball up high and then drop down on it. Spencer. Simpson, the other side. Back to Spencer. Simpson to Spencer. He'll shoot it. Deflected over the top of the net. Fleets on it. Pass for Spencer, or for Simpson rather. The time it got to her, Manitoba able to close. Oh, right at the blue line. Manitoba with a chance. They turn and go, but ball goes to the boards. Fleet will get there first. Emma Powell quickly to the boards, comes up with the ball. Great play by Emma Powell. Back to Westendorf. Backhanded in a little bit deeper, down into the corner. Got it in there. It was Drover. Gets it out to the blue line, and then up through center. Just missed Simpson. Alicia Powell. Hold it against the boards. Edmonds. Taken away by Edmonds. Edmonds off the boards to herself. Edmonds. Out in the corner. Kitchens in the high slot calling for it. Saunders was in the crease, so a crease violation against Newfoundland and Labrador. Faceoff comes outside the blue line. 5:02 left. Cleared in. Kitchen gets there first for Newfoundland Labrador. She goes down. No call. Saunders. Newberry backhanded it in. There's Rachel Hardy. Hardy's got it. Back at the point. Ryan in along the boards. It's going to be a penalty holding likely against Manitoba. Well, let's see, maybe not. No, it's going to go against Newfoundland and Labrador. Ryan down to the penalty box, holding. So with 4:09 left to go, Manitoba will go on the power play. Hiptich. They get it out down the floor. Simpson will get there first. Simpson to the boards. He's hoping to get it held against the boards. Manitoba do a good job to get it out. Up at the blue line. Brought in onside. Krochik back to Matani. Over to an open wing. Actually, this is Matani. Zikowicz made the pass, 16. That shot, right on goal, kicked away by Jones. Dortson. First shot, wide of the mark. They come out to center. They give it to Matani. Zikowicz, good save by Jones. You got the right pad down. Ball is still loose, it wasn't covered. Hear the hand for Jones coming from her bench. Teammates appreciate that. That was a huge save. There's still 3 minutes left to go. Simpson in there against Matani, the two captains. Matani coming away with it. Just got 30 seconds to go in the power play. Get it in, Zikowicz. Threw it right in front and cleared to the boards. Rachel Hardy on it, kept in by Alicia Powell. Powell with a shot. Jones has got that and holds on. 3:22 left. You see that last scramble. Well, that came so close to going in. It got past Jones. And just trickle past the post. Seconds left to go in the penalty to Newfoundland and Labrador. Face off in the Newfoundland and Labrador end. They lead it by 2. Manitoba goaltender has gone to the bench in favor of the sixth attacker. They do have a power play, so it's 6-on-4. Shot, Jones calmly grabs that out of the air. Good shot by Jesse Zikowicz. We'll redo that face-off. Over an hour off schedule. Not unusual. Right out in front, they hit the post. It's in, it's a goal. It hit, Jones hit the post, and then I think it hit her again and fell in behind. Plenty of life left for Manitoba. 1-goal game, 2 minutes left to go as they pulled the goalie with the power play and it paid off. In front, shot, it hit the post, yes, and went off Jones' right foot as she tried to come over. The post and then the goaltender's foot and then the back of the goal. So So we're in for a good finish here. 2 minutes, 2:07 to be exact. Just a one goal game. And the ball controlled by Manitoba from the faceoff. They'll swing it in. Spencer. Keeping an eye on Abby Glass down in the Manitoba end. She's still in the net. Looking for Simpson. That's going to be too far. That's going to be a faceoff back in the Newfoundland and Labrador end. 1:39 to go. Surely Glass will go to the bench now. Coach indicating come up halfway, come up a little more. Connie's got it. They're still leaving Glass there. And Newfoundland and Labrador have it. I think maybe if you had the sixth player out there, you could come up with that loose ball. That's always been my thought on this. Coaches wait, see, let's make sure we get possession of it before we take the goalie out. But if you're gambling, having the extra player out there would help you get possession. I've had this argument many times. She's still in the net. We'll get it. Now she makes her run. Just under a minute to go. Now Manitoba get the sixth player out there. They hold it against the boards. In there fishing for it is Hyatt. Thrown to the other side. On it first. Zikowicz. Back at the point. Matani has it. Maggie Matani. Towards the goal. It's blocked. Comes back to Matani. To the side of the goal, goes in behind. To the near boards. Kept in by Manitoba. That shot goes wide, goes to the other side. 20 seconds to go. Matani gets there first. Zikowicz to Matani, too far for her. We go against the boards. Matani's got it again. Throws it towards the net, that's blocked. Goes it back into the corner. 7 seconds. They battle for it there. Time is going to run out on Manitoba. What a finish, what a game. And now we get a little scrum as a couple of players went down along the boards over in the far side. Get the player up off the floor, a little dangerous down there. And Alicia Powell backs herself out of that and gets up. Labrador player, a little slower to get up. And cooler heads prevail. Teams are separated. Congratulations, Newfoundland and Labrador, under 20 girls team. Last year, the under 19s won the gold in St. John's. On their home floor. Tomorrow, they will go for gold in the under 20 here in Saskatoon. Manitoba will play for the bronze. Who will they be playing against? Well, we'll find out after the next game. Team BC, Withrow Park, up next in the other girls' under 20 semifinal. You don't want to miss that one. We've had some dandy semis, both semis. First one went to a shootout. Second one, handled well by my bearings again. So many games, so many teams.